Come, you blessed by my of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so as also celebrate the sacred mysteries. Your Son to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You're seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who gladden us year by year with the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, graciously grant that by celebrating these present festivities, we may merit through them to reach eternal joy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. One day, Peter and John were going up to the temple at the hour of prayer, at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and a man lame from birth was being carried in. People would lay him daily on the gate of the temple called the Beautiful Gate, so that he could ask for alms from those entering the temple. When he saw Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked them for alms. Peter looked intently at him, as did John, and said, "Look at us." And the man fixed his attention on them, expecting to receive something from them. Peter said, "I have no silver or gold, but what I have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, stand up and walk." And it took him by the right hand and raised him up. And immediately his feet and ankles were made strong. Jumping up, the man stood and began to walk. And he entered the temple with them, walking and leaping and praising God. All the people saw him walking and praising God, and they recognized him as the one who used to sit and ask for alms at the Beautiful Gate of the temple. And they were filled with wonder and amazement at what had happened to him. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, let all who seek the Lord rejoice. Let all who seek the Lord rejoice. I give thanks to the Lord, call on his name, make known his deeds among the peoples. Sing to him, sing praises to him, tell of all his wonderful works. Let all who seek the Lord rejoice. Glory in his glory in his holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Seek the Lord and his strength, seek his presence continually. Let all who seek the Lord rejoice. O offspring of his servant Abraham, children of Jacob, his chosen ones, he is the Lord our God. His judgments are in all the earth. Let all who seek the Lord rejoice. He is mindful of his covenant forever, of the word that he commanded for 1,000 generations, the covenant that he made with Abraham, his sworn promise to Isaac. Let all who seek the Lord rejoice.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. On the first day of the week, two of the disciples were going to a village called Emmaus, about 11 kilometers from Jerusalem. And while talking with each other about these things that had happened, while they were talking and discussing, Jesus himself came near and went with them, but their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And Jesus said to them, "What are you discussing with each other while you walk along?" They stood still, looking sad. Then one of them, whose name was Clopas, answered him, "Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have taken place there in these days?" Jesus answered them, "What things?" They replied, "The things about Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be condemned to death and crucified. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all this, it is now the third day since these things took place. Moreover, some women of our group astounded us. They were at the tomb early this morning, and when they did not find his body there, they came back and told us that they had indeed seen visions of angels, who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see him. Then Jesus said to them, "Oh, how foolish you are, and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have declared. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and enter into his glory?" Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them the things about himself in all the scriptures. As they came near the village to which they were going, he walked ahead as if he were going on. But they urged him strongly, saying, "Stay with us, because it is almost evening, and the day is now nearly over." So he went in to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized Jesus, and he vanished from their sight. The disciples said to each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road, and while he was opening the scriptures to us?" At the same hour they got up and returned to Jerusalem. And they found the 11 and their companions gathered there together. These were saying, "The Lord has risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon." Then the two disciples told what had happened on the road and how the Lord had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord. Probably the road to Emmaus, more than any scripture, gives us a wonderful understanding of the connection of the old and the new, and how the whole purpose of the Old Testament is fulfilled in the new, and the whole of the new is hidden within the old, and how we must always look for Christ in the old. So when people say the old is angry and the new is all full of lovey-dovey, you know, shepherd, lammy stuff, we must remember that there's this beautiful connection between the old and the new, and that as we look in the old, we must interpret it from the idea that it is a revelation of Christ and where he's going to come in our lives, and how important it is for us to spend that intimate time in sacred scripture and allow it to draw forth the truths of our life and our journey towards God, especially in sacred scripture. Brothers and sisters, filled with paschal joy, let us pray more earnestly to God that he who graciously listened to the prayers and supplications of his beloved Son may now be pleased to look upon us in our lowliness. We pray for our Holy Father Francis, for Pope Emeritus Benedict, for our Bishop Joseph, for their health, intentions, and constant growth in faith, hope, and charity. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, we pray, pray for the grace to truly look and find you in sacred scripture and to always have that beautiful and intimate relationship we're called to in reading scriptures. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, we pray for the grace to understand and love our baptism, to draw profit from that grace that was given to us. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for our country, our leaders, that they may make decisions that truly profit the people of our country and not just their ideals and their connections that they've made to line their own pockets. For this we pray to the Lord. Pray for all those who are taking away our religious rights and freedoms, for those who are espousing and embracing the culture of death, for the conversion of their souls, and for grace for people who stand up against them. For this we pray to the Lord. In this Mass, we pray in a special way for the repose of the soul of Soledad Zamora. For this we pray to the Lord. In a moment of silence, we offer up our own prayers and petitions. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all the holy souls in purgatory, and we ask them to join us with the saints and angels in heaven, especially St. Joseph, our Blessed Mother, St. Francis de La Salle, to pray for more vocations to the priesthood, to the consecrated life and the holy matrimony, to preserve all those in their vocations and assist us in our universal call to holiness. For this we pray to the Lord. O God, who knows that our life in this present age is subject to suffering and need, hear the desires of those who cry to you, and receive the prayers of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. receive, we pray, O Lord, the sacrifice which has redeemed the human race, and be pleased to accomplish in us the salvation of mind and body through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But above all, in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously. In Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, for he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising he has restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts, we sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they claim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Joseph our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, not in our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. disciples recognized the Lord Jesus in the breaking of the bread. Alleluia. Let us pray. We pray, O Lord, that the reverent reception of the sacrament of your Son may cleanse us from our old ways and transform us into a new creation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, alleluia.